stay hydrated. How's it, guys? Welcome back to another episode. In today's episode, Rob and myself, we are going to be chatting to you guys about spinnerbaits. Rods, reels, and lines. That's my part of this spinnerbait tutorial. I'm going to be talking about those three elements that are key to actually catching bass. Okay, let's talk about the reel. The reel, it doesn't matter what brand you guys get, but in this case, I've actually got the Daiwa Tatula. This is a 7:2:1 gear ratio that is absolutely key to fishing a spinnerbait. Let's talk about this pretty stuff. I only throw spinnerbaits on 15 pound fluorocarbon line. Other brands might vary from 14 to 16. Fluorocarbon, ultra key, 15 pound key. This is most probably gonna be very subjective to person to person. Me personally, I actually throw this Daiwa Tatula. This is actually their bladed jig rod and spinnerbait rod. This is actually a 7.4 foot rod, and it's a medium moderate action, meaning that it's got a very big parabolic bend, and when the fish actually bites the lure, it doesn't rip it out of its mouth immediately. It actually can suck that up, and your rod actually loads up really nicely, and you get that fish pinned. I'm pretty sure that Rob actually fishes a medium heavy. That's what I used to throw, and I actually throw this specific rod on a chatterbait. I'm a very big chatterbait fan, and I've been very successful with this. Every time I do get a bite, I never get a miss bite. If you guys are wondering what these little cans are that I've been drinking, 15 on Grace, go check out their website. I'll leave it linked down below. They are a sponsor of my channel, and they have it in sparkling water, which is this nice pretty black can, and they have one in a white, which is their still waters. Okay, enough of me talking about water. Let's shoot right to tackle cabin so that we can talk about these buggers, and then Rob will explain how you guys can fish a spinnerbait effectively to catch those big fish and just catch fish. So let's jump to tackle cabin. I'll see you guys there. Okay, so spinnerbaits are actually fairly simple to fish. I do know something about them. I just am very, very crappy at fishing them. I just have no confidence, and I generally go for a chatterbait instead of a spinnerbait. This is why I got Rob here. I think hearing it from somebody that has a lot of experience in fishing spinnerbaits. I'll leave his video linked down below when he went out to Aqua and he fished a spinnerbait in winter, and he did really, really well, and that's something I just can't do. So let's dive into this tutorial. I'll hold them. Is that it?
That's all you need. I'll just start on top.
First, spinnerbait. We literally got three spinnerbaits here. So let's start off at the top.
Now, I just want to explain blades quick and how they work, why they work. You know, first off, you got that is a willow blade. You'll see it's quite narrow at the top, gets a bit bigger, gets narrow at the end. Now this thing spins a million miles an hour. It is great for burning, covering water, getting to structure, things like that. It is awesome. I'll get back to that shortly. Next one, something slightly different. We have the willow Colorado combination. This is a very good all-rounder. It does a bit of everything. Lastly, we have what most people consider the most boring one, the stock standard Colorado blade. Very, very thin taper again, but it has a massive, massive ball at the end. It kind of looks like a teardrop. And this guy slowly turns and thumps. When you hear the guys, the pros talking about that thumping spinnerbaits, that is the blade they're talking about that gives the most thumping action. So, going back to the top. Double willow. When, why, how, what, who. This is a great bait for getting in and out of cover, in and out of trees. Surprisingly, this guy does skip quite well with these blades. I don't know why, I just have a knack of skipping it. This one right here has a Terminator P1, I believe. sneaky little...
What are they called?
In store right now. So when you're looking for the cruising fish, the guys that are sitting, waiting to ambush, the fish that are very similar to like a Texas rig, they'll just come out and smash it on the spots. That's definitely the place to go for. Next one. The Willow Colorado combination. This guy still moves pretty darn fast, but that little Colorado blade gives that extra thump. In the colder weathers, this is more your early spring, late autumn kind of thing. It works. The Willow blade turns so fast, it's ridiculous. And that little, as small as it is, that little tiny Colorado adds a little bit of extra thump, which sometimes gives that a little bit of a death wobble that you sometimes see on a spinnerbait. Last one, once again, the Colorado blade. Slow turning, churning, thump, thump, thump. This is the one that looks like a really slow moving crankbait where your rod tip goes doof, 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 doof. This guy is great. When fish are lethargic, they're bored, they don't want to chase anything, they don't know what to eat, this guy is the absolute shiz. Trailers, I'm a big fan of no trailer. I cannot stand a trailer on a spinnerbait, but that's just me personally. I know a lot of guys like Sash himself puts a nice little paddle tail on the back. On the very rare occasion I do throw a trailer on the back, it is a small, tiny 2.5-3 inch paddle tail. If not that, then it's definitely a junior fluke or something along those lines, just to give it a bit of an extra tail wobble, just a slight little more traction. And that's what I go for. I try and match the trailer to the color of the skirt. So if it's a chartreuse white, I'll put it on a plain chartreuse or a plain white. If it's a black spinnerbait, I would throw a much darker, like a green pumpkin or a Mardi Gras, or not Mardi Gras, watermelon candy, or a black itself. Again, just something that adds a bit of an extra bulk to the trailer rather than just the skirt.
Okay, another thing you guys can see, there's an extra hook at the bottom that is called a trailer. I do know why you put a trailer. It's mainly if a fish is mishitting this bait and you just put a little trailer hook on the back and you should get that bite, or you should hook that fish.
So in terms of trailer hook, I religiously fish spinnerbaiter trailers, and it's a confidence thing. I prefer throwing it with a trailer hook because I know if you short strike, if he misses that first hook, that second hook is always in play, and you'll see the second hook, if you ignore those two, it's just past the skirt. So he has absolutely no reason to miss it. Like I said in the jig video, moving baits, I generally don't touch the skirt. I leave it as is. I like it nice and bulky and flared out. And the more skirt you have, the more of the death rattle, the death shimmer you have. As you can see, if it were short, it would be out there in the middle of nowhere like a jig, like how you want it. But on a spinnerbait, you want that little extra flare edge, the shimminess. Guys do tend to cut them down, but if they do, it's just a tiny, tiny pinch off the end, like literally like a centimeter, like that much. This is a bait where it's literally everyone to your own. You can't go wrong, you can't go right. Well, you can't go right, obviously, if you're catching fish, but it is very, very, very difficult to go wrong.
It's called colors. That's a very, very important question.
The most important question, more than likely. I don't know how to explain this one, but again, colors is a very, very big confidence deal. If you are confident with chartreuse, throw a chartreuse. If you're confident with white, throw white. If you are starting out, two colors I would highly, highly suggest. A plain white, such as that. It's not very common, but I go for a much darker spinnerbait, like that guy right there, nice and dark, got a good green pumpkin in it, but a back black, and there's a couple of pink accents in it, which is very, very nice. And then probably the most sought after spinnerbait is a plain old chartreuse one. I personally do not like chartreuse. I like a pinch of chartreuse. I don't like the entire thing to be chartreuse.
Pinch of chartreuse.
Yeah, pinch of chartreuse. So yeah, color again, personal preference. Like a lot of bass fishing, is personal preference. But you can't really go wrong with your whites, your naturals like your green pumpkins and blacks, and things like that. A big misconception is that chartreuse white is the best color known to man. Personal preference. Tend to stick to South African waters, the South African colors, so your darker stuff, your white with a bit of something extra. It mimics the silver catfish, your juvenile barbel, your carp especially. And in the winter time, a lot of our bait fish go a lot dull, like this kind of color or this kind of color. And they tend to lose a lot of their color, so their whites with a bit of, or the off-white is what I like to say, seems to do the job slightly better.
Spinnerbaits is a very subjective thing and it's all personal preference. If I have one advice for you guys, and you guys are very, very into the sport and want to spend some more money, get one of each color. Like, I stick to three colors mainly: chartreuse white and maybe a natural little bit darker color, and it goes for every watercolor. So you have it in your box, you're always covered for all water clarities.
That is absolute dead on.
I hope that this video clarifies some of your guys' questions about what spinnerbait to actually use. I am going to be leaving Rob's videos linked down below. He does really, really well with the spinnerbait. I personally don't. As I said, I would rather pick up a chatterbait. It is just my preferred bait with a blade. Yeah, so go check out Rob's videos. Maybe his videos can teach you something. And that's all we've got for you today. I hope that you guys enjoyed this little tutorial about spinnerbaits. Leave comments down below, hit that thumbs up, subscribe to this guy because he's awesome and his videos are really, really good. And I know that you guys showed him some love in the last video. Do that again, please. So yes, we'll check you guys in the next one.
Appreciate you.